In today's video, here is a nice problem. It's coming from Baltic Wave Mathematical Olympiad, edition 2011. Here is the following setup. We have f as a function from real number to real number. So we have this composite form, f of x equals x squared minus x plus number 1. So the question we are going to determine f of 0, okay? So this is very straightforward question. It's not hard at all, okay? Just we are going to apply the some tricks here in order to calculate f of 0. So let's set f of 0 equals a and f of 1 equals b, okay? So we are going to look for f of 0, okay? Let's set f of 0 equals a. We don't know the value yet, so let's help this one by calculating f of 1, okay? So let's make the combination between these two outputs in order to find f of 0, okay? I'm going to calculate f of 0 by this application, okay? So when we have f of 0 equals a, this implies f of 0 equals f of a, okay? So let's name this one as the equation number 1. Also, I'm going to apply the same thing here on this one. So we have f of 1 equals b implies f of 1 equals f of b. Okay, let's name this one as a equation number 2. So also we know f of 0 by plugging x with 0 here, I get number 1. So we know this one equals to f of a, okay? So we found the value of f of a equals number 1, okay? Let's also work on the second one. Let's calculate f of 1. So also we know f of 1 by plugging x with number 1 here, I get 1 minus 1 plus number 1, which is equals 1. Also f of 1 equals f of b, okay? This is one side. Let's work on the other side. So we get this one. We get f of a equals 1, okay? Also, we get f of b equals number 1, okay? Let's apply one more time f of a by this application on this one. So I get f of a equals f of 1. Let's do the same thing here. f of b equals f of 1, okay? Now let's calculate f of a by using the original function, okay? Let's by plugging x with a. So I get also f of a equals a squared minus a plus number 1. This one equals to f of 1, okay? Equals to f of 1. We know f of 1 equals b, okay? Let's do the same thing here. Instead to put a, I'm going to put b here. So I'm going to apply f of b by plugging x with b here. I get b squared minus b plus number 1. Also, we know f of b equals f of 1 here. But f of 1 equals b, okay? Let's solve the second equation. So I get here, by taking b to the left side, I get b squared here minus 2b plus number 1 equals 0, okay? We have a form quadratic expression here. So this one is a perfect square, so we know b minus number 1 quinary square equals 0. So this one implies b equals 1. So we get the value of b here. Let's take this value of b and insert it back into this one here. This one equals 1. So let's solve this equation by canceling out number 1 from both sides. I will be left with this one. I get a squared minus a equals 0. Equivalent by taking a as a common factor, a is multiplied by a minus number 1 equals 0. This one is giving us two solutions, a equals 0 or a equals 1. Okay? let's go through two cases. Case number one, if a equals zero, by plugging the value of a into this one here, so this one is telling us f of zero equals zero. Okay, this one implies f of zero equals f of zero. We know f of zero equals zero. Okay, but we know f of zero by plugging zero with by plugging x with zero here equals number one. It's clearly it's a contradiction. It's impossible because we found f of zero equals zero, but f of zero equals number one by this one, which is impossible. Which means e equals zero, it's impossible. This one is a rolled out of this possibility, so a equals one is a right one. So which means f of zero equals number one. So we found the value of zero, which equals number one. Okay. So I have ended this video. By the way, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and support the channel. And thank you for watching. We'll see you next video. Bye.